Why Muay Thai though? It was big in the 80s. You were probably not even born yet when it was peaking.
I don't know. Brian, can I say this?
You can say whatever you want.
Can I say the reason why, what I told you yesterday? Why Muay Thai, why boxing?
Why Muay Thai?
No, this is gonna end up on YouTube. Can I tell him? Should I say it? Well, honestly, I never really liked Muay Thai. I was just really good at it. I actually really wanted boxing, but I couldn't seem to make it work for me, you know, whatever the reason may be. But if you look at my boxing fights, I had no head movement, no feints, no, I didn't even know how to go under a punch. I didn't even know how to slip anything, catch anything, nothing. And I fought boxing like that, so obviously I'm gonna have a fucked up boxing record.
So you switched too?
Well, no, I was doing Muay Thai first. That was the first thing that I did. And then just like the right coach came along in Muay Thai and we clicked and then, you know, we fucking won 8 world titles. It was like an easy thing. Tell but like, honestly, I wanted boxing. I've always wanted boxing. I didn't want to do that. I was just, I don't know. I was afraid to dig that deep in myself, you know?
Tell everybody where to follow you on Instagram.
Miriam Nakamoto. Sorry, I'm thinking my email. Miriam Nakamoto, shit.
Miriam, let me ask you this though.
But now I'm ready. I'm coming back to boxing.
Why not do MMA though? Why not do UFC?
That shit. I'm not gonna get any more fucking knee surgeries. I've had four. I'm good. And honestly, I want boxing. I don't want MMA. I want boxing. I've been a coward, avoiding what I really want. What's in my heart and my passion and you know my dream. And I avoided it for a really long time. And I'm just not willing to do. It's too uncomfortable to stay here. I got to do this. I got to pursue it. The window's closing for me. I'll be 46 soon. You know, and
you look much younger. That's good.
Well, no kids and just fighting. You know, for 23 years.
You live in Hawaii, right?
No. Oh, here.
Okay, but you're Hawaiian originally?
No, I'm a Japanese, white, black, Native American, but I was born in Hawaii.
Okay. Because Hawaii?
Yeah, Hawaii.
Everyone's from Hawaii.
Yeah.
Hey, Hawaiian Gardens.
Yeah, but honestly, like anything, if you're gonna look back in your old age and you're gonna regret it, like you'll never be able to let it go. You always look back with regret.
Should've,
that's something that you have to do.
Yep.
Even if it seems fucking crazy to come back to fighting.
But Miriam, if you're a fighter,
46 years old.
But if you're a fighter, you're a fighter.
Yeah.
You know, and you give it a shot.
Right.
Ready?
Yeah.
So you're gonna do pro boxing? Have you had pro boxing fights yet?
Yeah, I have, and they're shit.
Okay, but now you're gonna try it round two.
I'm gonna do what Brian tells me. If Brian tells me I don't have the goods, he'll tell me, and I will agree because I'm not really here for participation medals. And you know, it's popular in this day and age, this generation. And if he tells me we're good and we're proceeding forward, then that's what we're doing.
Miriam, who's your favorite fighter all time? And whether it's boxing, MMA, Muay Thai, like
I don't have all time, but I love Sugar Ray Robinson and Sanchai. Muay Thai and boxing. That was
what about modern day? Like active? Do you follow anybody? Do you like anybody?
Canelo. Yeah.
He's fighting May 7th against Bivol, who's a bigger weight class, who's a champion, undefeated.
I don't have any predictions.
You're just going to watch it? But you like Canelo. What do you tell Canelo if he's watching?
What's that?
What do you tell Canelo if he's watching?
Like, I don't tell him nothing. Like,
good luck on your fight.
I'm really grateful that he does what he does, because then people like me get to watch him do what he does, and we get to learn from him. You know, it's amazing. It's amazing how he's so evasive, but he's so relentless.
Okay.
So I love it.
You've been a world champion 8 times, right?
Yeah.
Do you have 8 different belts? Is it one? How does that work?
Win
the title and then you defend it.
So I've only defended one belt once.
Okay.
A bunch of them were vacant, or it was like a world tournament, but it was very respected. It
like WBC or in Muay Thai as
WBC.
Well?
WBC.
So you're a WBC champion in Muay Thai?
2 times, yeah.
Nice. So your house looks like a Hall of Fame?
No, I just have them on a shelf collecting dust. I don't care.
It's not your motivation?
No, it wasn't what it was about. I thought I would be a different person if I won those things, and I would feel differently inside, and that actually was not the case.
It lasted 5 minutes, and then it fizzled out.
No, it never lasted. It was actually, I got really depressed after.
Why?
I just don't really feel like I was being authentic, you know? And if you're not really being the highest expression of yourself, you can't really be proud of it, even if you didn't.
But you should be proud. Not everybody's a champion. You're a champion 8 times. I would be walking around with 8 belts right now. They're heavy.
It wasn't about that. It was about being honest and authentic and myself. And it was about cutting my heart open and pouring it out on the canvas. And I didn't do that.
But you still won.
I still won, but I didn't do that. So is this
maybe work. You're so good.
It doesn't feel good, though. I don't know. People can't relate to what I'm saying. And I get it. And that's fine. You know, but I know when I'm not being honest. And it doesn't matter. I could lose, but have fought my heart out and put everything on the line and like give it my 100% best, you know, and lost. And that would be more satisfying than an empty victory.
Miriam, if you weren't in fighting, what would you be doing full time? What's your other passion?
I haven't been able to let go fighting go in 9 years, man. Almost 9 years. In December, it'll be 9 years since my knee blew out. What would I be doing? Maybe acting a stunt or, you know.
That's good.
Yeah, I think I need something that you can like kind of pour everything in there and just immerse yourself, right? Just put everything you got in there. And then some people do it with kids. I don't know if that's healthy, but I do it with fighting and creative project.
All right, there you have it, everybody. You should follow you once again. Instagram was Miriam.
Miriam Nakamoto.
Spell Nakamoto.
N A K A. M-O-T-O.
Like you sounds. Perfect.
Nakamoto.
So there you have it. Stay tuned and be careful. She could kick you. She could punch you. Stay tuned. Ellie, take back. Reporting. Can you do that in Muay Thai?
Left the way you can. I would have fought that.
If you could do it, if you could get away with it. But you're not supposed to, right?
No. You're not supposed to headbutt.
Right. Like in boxing, you're not supposed to hit on the belt line, but you do it.
Yeah, but left the way. You can actually, it's an art.
Of course it's an art. If the referee's in the right angle.
No, it's headbutting. It's literally legitimately headbutting.
There's a workout for that. Okay, so let's
say. That would be the one time that I would do a Muay Thai fight again if it was left away.
Okay, so let's say this is the opponent's head.
I don't want to put my head on that one.
Okay. Well, it's not that. Okay.
It's better with a body.
A body? Like this one is better?